I've kind of written this for the more sort of club scenario, it's not too wide. Certain things are quite wide, but yeah, so this is kind of your left and right. In terms of actual space, let's kind of like use your ears for that, really. Yeah.
If you're making a club track, then obviously you want a little bit of mono.
Yeah.
How wide would you go for a club-based track? As far as sort of hard pan.
Well, it depends. If you check, the main worry with that is just is kind of phase cancellation, basically. But most club PAs are in mono, so they kind of sum the signal, and it will come out of the speakers in mono. So the only thing you've got to worry about is if you're, when you're monitoring or when you're mixing, if you A and B between stereo and mono are amplified and quiet at the same time. When you've got something out of phase, it's doing the opposite. Okay, so it's cool. I like the rhythm, but again, slightly out of time. And for electronic music, that's quite important, really. Because you know you want everything to be locked in time, and everything else. So I'm going to flex this as well. So again, flex is on at the top. I'm going to go down here and again slicing. So we've got the slices in there. So again, I can do go up to the parameters box, quantize it, which I'm going to do quickly first anyway. So just quantize it to 16ths. And what sidechain does is basically I'm telling the compressor to look at audio one, which is the kick drum, and use that as a controller, like a trigger, to initialize the compressor. And what a compressor does is controls volume over time, basically, it controls dynamics of volume over time. So what I'm doing is I'm getting the compressor to look at the kick drum, and every time the kick drum hits, the compressor's gonna start swashing. Completely in time with the kick. So, to take my gain down to zero, I'm going to boost any gain, yeah? Yeah, I think at the end of the day, music is music, and where there are certain rules of certain sounds, and they are produced in different ways, I think if you make the more kind of different types of music that you make, I think the better your main chosen genre will be. So I've got it set to 512, that's a good buffer level to be working at. But you're going to get like half a second of latency. Or maybe not that long, you know, enough latency. But when you're recording, you want to set it to something like 32, and then you don't get any latency. That's going into the ante phase, because it's so off. So yeah, you're just going to get problems with things like cancellation when it gets summed, because they're so off. I think it's a bit silly for anyone just to be like, oh, I'm a drum and bass producer, or oh, I'm a house producer, or I'm a techno producer. It's like, why would you kind of limit yourself to that kind of, you know, those kind of four walls of what you do? It just doesn't make much sense.